say something?
Never.
You have the nearest neighbor.
Never.
To your country. I can't. But since I became a knight,
don't take it.
But the younger person should pass it for too long.
To be chronicled. A government college in Umuahian, Old Boys Association magazine on television. In this episode, I have two great Umuahians in the house, Dr. Ed Chukukere and Mr. Chukukere, all to be chronicled on their memorable events while in school. Who said I'm not excited? I am, because today I have the privilege to drink from the fountain of knowledge. I also have in the house Lower Axis Chapter, led by its able chairman, Engineer Emmanuel, and also my brother Joe Mweke is in the house too. I am Victor Okoro, class 72, Night House, your uncle and chronic lab.
Boss.
Government College Umuahian, founded 1929, is a foremost citadel of learning east of the Niger. This college, whose first principal was Reverend Robert Fisher, is known for its academic excellence from inception to the present day, churning out quality and brilliant points who have made and will continue to make indelible marks in their chosen fields of endeavor in terms of achievement by excellence in the Nigerian society and even beyond the shores of Nigeria. Notable men, men of exceptional qualities, men of timber and caliber, men whose extraordinary intelligent quotient would have taken this country out of its doldrum if their services were valued and employed. Government College Umuahian, no doubt, is a reservoir of great minds who are knowledgeable and vast in both ancient and contemporary events, and also wielding ideas, intelligence, and charisma that can, to a large extent, evolve solutions to the present-day problems of Nigeria and beyond. As part of this great and noble institution of international repute, I will not hesitate to chronicle the achievements of these great Umuahians, kickstarting with Dr. Ed Chukukere and Barrister Trudy Onuso. Dr. Chukukere is an engineer by profession, a can-do engineer, not a paper engineer. A man of excellence. I'm going to start off the question this way. Sir, I am the most privileged younger Umuahians to drink from the fountain of your knowledge as an ancient school boy. Kindly share with me one of your memorable events in your early days in school.
One of my memorable events. Well, you got to answer.
So many.
But one I remember most is the college song, the college anthem.
Yes.
We were given an impromptu test at preparatory class. One afternoon, 1.5 hour prep class. And the test was just one question. The master was Mr. Charles Lowe, an Australian teacher in English. The question was, write any poem on any topic on with Turkey or iambic tetrameter.
Wow.
In Turkey or iambic tetrameter, these are meters describing the rhythm in a poem. And these two are the most elementary rhythms. Iambus says, tetam, when you write the poem, it will sound like tetam, 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 tetam. Troche says, tam, tetam, 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 in short, the reverse. We have 1.5 hours to write the poem. And I just wrote the 4 stanzas within that 1.5 hours. I thought nothing of it until the master, Charles Lowe, came back the following day, waving my copy of the poem. So he came to me. I said, look, tell me the truth, how you wrote this poem. I mean, where you copied this poem from. I told him, there's no question of copying, because we didn't even know that you give us a test on poetry.
Yes.
But I chose the college motto in Udum Rukayan. May this shine as one. No. In Udum Rukayan meant, may this shine in one.
In one.
So I used that as the topic of the poem. I just wrote the poem. Mr. Lowe kept going everywhere, told me again, he came back to me, after consulting a lot of people, he came back to me and said, look, you are getting your 20 over 20, 100% for the poem, even if you copied it. Just tell me where you copied it from. I repeated the same answer, and then he said, I believe you. Then he ran to the principal and showed him the poem. The principal was excited, and he told his wife to come and persuade me to disclose where I copied it from. Because the wife liked me a lot. She was a mathematics master.
Okay.
And she was a graduate of Cambridge.
Wow.
Even the principal was a graduate of Cambridge. Mr. Lowe was a graduate of Oxford. And the two of them were always fighting. Which university was the best. Now, Mrs. Simpson came and talked to me. I went back to the husband and I said, he wrote everything. And that was how it was. But it did not become the college anthem until I left the school.
Wow.
It was 2 years after I left the school.
Who was responsible?
So that was my most memorable. The second one was, of course, the day I won my boxing colors.
Wow.